Good afternoon and welcome to this short webinar about how to transform ideas into real pilot, real projects. Before starting the presentation, I just would like to give you a little bit of context. So with this webinar, we want to share with you, with our public, some best practices to start the digitalization journey in Industry 4.0. So this webinar wants to address to specific people working in heavy industry and raw materials, such as, just to mention a few, steel, cement, lime, or mining as well. Also considering that we have worked in this domain for the last 6 years to help company or to facilitate a company to integrate AI to optimize production processes. So this is a bit the context in which we work, and as well, just a couple of info about myself. My name is Martina. I started in Wizzata 3 years ago as a project manager, and now I'm currently transitioning to account manager. And my background is more into social sciences with a focus on project management and business administration. So coming back to the webinar, this will take around 10-15 minutes. And at the end of the presentation, you will have some time to write your remarks or ask a question. So feel free to write into the chat, and I will be glad to take your comments and answer. So we are ready to go. First slide. So let's say that we want to move from ideas or problems into project execution, so into define a pilot to start the digitalization journey into our company. We have four, let's call them milestones, so four main steps. The first one is the workshop organization and the selection of the resources. The second one is the actual discussion and the definition of the ideas. The third one is the evaluation and somehow the ranking of the projects, of the ideas that we gather. And the fourth and last is to select one final project to move forward. So let's take a look deeper into each milestone, into each phase. So we start with the workshop organization and the selection of the resources. So in terms of organizing the workshop, this is a bit up to you, how you want to structure that. Our advice is always to try to split the workshop into different domains. So this means that you organize one workshop for quality issues, one workshop where you define, where you discuss maintenance problems or yield, for example. So try to keep it divided with the several with the different domains. In terms of duration, normally 1 day per domain should be enough to go at least to cover at least the first 3 steps. So to go from brainstorming to idea definition and to the ranking of the idea or the ideas. Sorry, but of course this is also up to you, to your internal organization. You can also decide to do 2 half days, so it doesn't have to be 8 hours in full. So this is something that you can definitely decide. Of course, you organize the workshop in the way you want. You can use post-it if you want to make it a little bit more, you know, dynamic. And what is very important is that you involve the right profiles. So you want to involve, for example, automation and process engineers. You want to have business experts as well. You want to include as well operators and IT people, for example, because they know how to get the data, where the data are stored. You want to involve as well, for example, someone from the research department, because maybe they are already working on something that can be useful into your project. And of course, if you have an innovation or digitalization department, you can include those people as well. And finally, also to have someone from management is also good to somehow guide you through the strategy of the company. And why do we need to involve all these people? The reason is because each person can bring to the table a different problem, but also a different perspective, so a different angle to the same problem. And of course, you also want to generate a kind of a discussion, kind of a flow. So we suggest that you always include between 7 and 10 people. So this is a kind of a not too little, but not too many. So it's a good balance that works. Moving forward to the second step, so the definition of the ideas. So basically, you have organized the workshop, you have a brainstorming session where you discuss, you trigger different ideas. And the first part of the brainstorming, of course, has to be really a flow, a dynamic flow. Then you move, once you have collected all the ideas, you move forward to something a little bit more structured. So you need to define each single ideas that you have gathered. And the way we suggest to do it is to have a list of questions that you address, that you answer for each problem, for each idea that you have gathered. In this way, it will also be easier at the end to evaluate the different problems, because like this, you will have a structured description, you will have the same information for all the ideas, so it will be easier to evaluate. So how to define these ideas? So try to answer questions like what keeps you awake at night, or what are the recurring problems that you have daily, that you have in your daily routine on the line? What is the impact of that specific problem? If you can come up even with already a measure, already an idea of the ROI, it's even better. What do you expect from the project? So is it a root cause analysis that you want to do, or better to have a prediction, or better to have a system that recommends values, optimal values to you? So really try to dig in and limit the scope, the output, and the objective of the problem, of the project. And as well, identify who could be the final user. So who are the people that actually will need to use this system, will consume the final output of the problem. Once you, let's say, answer all these questions that are more business related, related to the scope of the project, then move to describe, to discuss the data. So what is the data availability? Are data available? Where are the data stored? How can we access this data? Do we need to purchase additional hardware or software? Do I need just historical data, or do I need the data to be able to work on the data in real time? So really try to define a little bit what is the data assessment. Of course, at this stage, we are talking about something very preliminary. It's not a feasibility assessment, but it's just really a basic data assessment to move then forward. So let's say that you have collected all the list of your ideas. You also describe them in a fairly specific way. And then you have to put now a little bit of order among all these ideas and evaluate and rank them. So we suggest to create a matrix to evaluate the overall complexity of the of each problem, of each ideas. And we think there are three main factors to evaluate. The first one is actually the business score, or ROI. So you need to evaluate how important it is for the strategy of your company to have such a project developed. You can give a rank between 1 and 5. Then evaluate the data assessment as well. So are the data poor? Is the data set poor? Or the data are kind of available? And overall, evaluate the complexity. I know it's hard at the beginning to really evaluate the complexity of a project, but you are the business expert, so you probably already know since the start if it's something very complex or something that can be easily developed, easily solved. Of course, we always also suggest not to start with a very complex project. So do not start, for example, with the automation of a furnace, because it's already kind of a big project to embark on, but try to have something small, like maybe focus on an equipment, that is malfunctioning, or focus on a specific typology of product. Maybe you have a very high quality product that is causing specific issues, then focus on that specific product. So try always to keep the scope somehow a little bit limited. And yeah, this is actually the ranking metrics that I was talking about before. So also, please, if you want me to share with you this document, this template, feel free to ask me after the meeting. We have a couple of templates that we can share with you, and this is one of them. So we have a ranking matrix with the where you can see which, based on your evaluation, based on the notes, you can see in which how the complexity it is. And of course, ideally, you want to select a project that is in the top right quadrant. So it means very high business priority, but low complexity. So ideally, this would be a nice project to start with. And yeah, finally, so once you have selected a couple of, once you have your matrix, and you have selected 2-3 potential projects, probably you need to refer to the management. You can either to the management or either to the team, to your team, you can present a couple of opportunities or a couple of potential projects and decide together on which one to focus to start with. Also, we always advise that the first pilot should not last more than 4 to 6 months. So you do not really want, as a first attempt, to focus on a project that lasts years. So this is, let's say, the time frame that we advise you to follow. So a small pilot between 4 and 6 months, so you can deliver fast result. And as well, another thing is always try to divide the project, the pilots, into smaller milestones, so that you iterate and little by little you can somehow lower down the risks of a final failure. So this is a bit what I prepared for you today to discuss. Here you have my contacts in case you want to, even after the call, you want to contact me with questions or specific remarks, or you want to discuss some ideas. And I would open now the floor for questions. So feel free to ask your questions or make any remark. So let me just check. So the first question I see is, if we consider starting a project, should we wait to be sure to have all data needed or install sensor before moving forward? So actually, this is a good question, something that often, let's say, pops up during conversation. I heard this question quite a lot. And let's say, on one side, I understand that in an AI project, we are very much focused on the quality of the data, on the availability of the data, and most of us probably would target a perfect database before the project. But actually, this is not really the optimal workflow, the optimal process, because when you start a project, first you don't know exactly which data you need. So it's hard to say, okay, this data set is perfect or this data set is wrong. And somehow is also, let's say, a side effect or a takeaway of the project to create awareness around the data, and to somehow, one of the possible outcome of the project is also that you have to improve your data set. And the data set can be improved endless. So it's hard to say, so we always, advise overall to start small and grow then your data based on the internal needs, on the specific needs of the project. So let me check as well for, I saw another question. So It's actually two questions. So evaluate and rank ideas. How do you execute it to be efficient and stay focused? Do you build ranking metrics on the fly or after the session? How to adapt to the COVID era with online interaction taking the lead? Okay, so let's start with the first one regarding how to execute the, how to evaluate the idea and stay focused. So of course, let's say you have all the list of your ideas. Maybe at this point, when you really need to, when you need to evaluate the risk, maybe you can try to reduce a little bit the group of people only to the specialists, because you will have many ideas triggered by many by different people. Maybe at that point, when you need to really evaluate, better to sit just with the experts, with the people that really have the knowledge related to that idea that they brought up. So this is a way to let's say make it efficient without discussing with too many people. Second question: how to build the ranking matrix? No, you don't actually build it on the fly. As I said, I can share with you a template, but it's something really easy. You have a template, you fill it in with the numbers, and automatically it will reflect into the different quadrants. So, but this is, I can share it with you without problem. So it's something already done. And how to adapt to the COVID era with online interaction? Yes, it's true that, let's say, COVID doesn't facilitate things. We have seen it also in the last 9 months, in the last 8 months. But it's possible, though. We moved from very interactive project, going on site, visiting the line, and talking to the people physically on in the location. We moved to a fully remote working environment, and it's still working. What you need to, let's say, what you need to pay attention to is really to make the business integration into your company or in the environment where you are working. So make sure that IT, business experts, and as well data scientists or the people responsible for creating the models for the data are really talking to each other, and they really need to believe in this project. So we saw, based on our experience, that when you create such a synergy, it really works. The project is successful. If there is no let's say no engagement from all the different parties, then the project may not be so successful. So it's really creating a momentum as well, creating a synergies between the different departments. So I think there are no more questions. So thank you very much, everybody, for joining this webinar. And do not hesitate to come back to me in the next few days, in the next few weeks. Thank you. Bye-bye.